congratulations, gentlemen. This one, I don't even know what to say. I walked out of it, my heart is still pounding. How does Chris Nolan do this? He keeps stepping it up with each film that he does.
It's amazing, isn't it?
You'll have to ask him, because I'm telling you, I'm like you. I'm just going, how do you do that?
Yeah. He's like a computer. He knows everything that he wants to do, and he's so quiet. You ask him the most minuscule little thing, and he has an answer for it.
Yeah.
You know, and he knows. He cuts in his head, too. The camera in his head, you know? Oh, he's amazing.
He is amazing. What is it like to just watch that man in action and how he keeps everything so...
Can't tell you what it's like to watch him. I'll tell you what it's like to work with him.
Yeah.
He's quiet authority.
That's it. That really describes him. And the thing about him, he has this coat with a flask of tea in it, and he drinks his tea all day long.
Yeah, a raggedy old coat. I think that's a good luck thing.
A raggedy old coat. It's the same overcoat.
And he takes a sip of this tea about every 10, 20 minutes.
And I found out what the tea was. It was Earl Grey tea. Yeah, and that's what he drinks. And he's a tea drinker, and he's watching, you know. He's an Englishman as well. He's drinking tea all day long, you know.
I was really a puddle of tears after this film. Very emotional story. Really, my God, how did you get through the scenes with Christian? There's a couple that I don't want to give anything away in these interviews, but...
I was a method actor, sort of. I trained in method when I was very young, and I picked up a couple of things from Stanislavski. One of them was sense memory. Mm. If you go back to a time whenever you want to be really emotional, and I have a moment, which I've never told even my wife what the moment is, you know, but it's a family moment, which makes me, and I can cry, I rarely cry.
Drop of a hat.
Bang, like that, I can go bang, straight into it. I'm not going to do it now because my eyes will be red for the next interview and they'll wonder what I'm up to.
And
I wanted a Barbara
could.
Walters moment, come on.
Do yeah, Barbara makes everyone cry, doesn't she?
Never been able to, one time. And they didn't take the shot.
Yeah, I've never cried. I rarely, oh, please God, must I say that? Keep away from that.
But the two of you are the father figures of sorts, Batman, to Bruce Wayne, and to watch the evolution of somebody like Christian Bale from, it's been 9 years since you guys have been working with him. Morgan, first, you know, just watching his evolution, watching how he's grown as an actor, what's that been like for you to watch him?
I don't know. We all hope that we're growing as actors with, you know, each day that passes. I didn't know Chris's work when we first did. So afterwards, I got to see a lot of the stuff he'd done prior. Like,
psychological. Yeah, I saw that one too, yeah. He did some very difficult roles.
Awesome. The Machinist.
Yeah.
Golly.
And he always, the last time film I saw, before I did the first Batman, the last film I saw him, it was this skinny little guy on a prisoner or something somewhere, and they were holding him. And on the first day of Batman, in walked Arnold Schwarzenegger, you know. And I thought, how the hell did he do that?
How did he do that?
You know, I was trying to lose 3 pounds and couldn't do it.
Right.
It's astounding. Isn't it, you know, refreshing as actors to be able to keep something so secretive? I mean, I'm so glad that as an audience viewer just knew nothing going in. And
isn't that good that you know nothing?
Absolutely.
Well, how are you going to write about the movie and not say anything?
I'm not going to say a thing. I don't want people to know. The surprises for me were the best part of this film, I think.
Yeah, well, that's the thing. It's why you cry and everything. You know, even though it's, you know. And the great thing about Chris is what he does, which is so clever as a director for me, is you've got all this CGI and computers and stuff. You can do. He doesn't do any of that. If a guy falls off the Empire State Building, it's a real guy falling onto a couple of boxes, you know? And it's no, and if there's 11,000 people walking down Broadway Street or in a football field, there's 11,000 people there. The only time I was ever in a scene where he used CGI was when 6 million bats came in, and we were quite pleased. We had about three bats, and they turned them in, you know, fluttering around, and they turned them in $2 million.
A flock.
Yeah.
Yeah, I'd be happy about that, too, for sure.
Yeah.
Let's just talk shortly about the newbies on set. Okay, first off, Anne Hathaway. I mean, really?
Oh,
awesome
fabulous.
Girl.
Lovely.
Awesome.
Lovely.
I shouldn't even use girl term for her. She's an awesome woman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And absolutely ideal for Catwoman, you know.
Fantastic.
She's wonderful.
Yeah. Tom Hardy. What can I say? Bane. Is he not?
Tom, I saw on British television. I'd never heard of him. And he came on British television as like a Cockney gangster in the area that I come from, so I knew what was right and what was wrong. And he was the toughest gangster I had ever seen on British television, or anyway, including me. I played a couple of gangsters. He made me look like Mary Poppins. And he was the toughest guy. And then you meet him, and he's a sweetheart. He is Mary Poppins.
Well, that's always the way that the hardest guys in the movies are always the softest touches in
real
life.
Yeah, the softest touches. Yeah, yeah. And he's a wonderful actor and a lovely guy. He's great in this.
Although I don't know anybody that ever beat you in Get Carter.
Oh, Get Carter. Yeah, I played a gangster
in
that.
You were kind of rough.
That was rough.
Yeah, that was kind of rough. Joseph Gordon-Levitt. Another. Like, this kid's going to be another amazing actor.
Yeah.
What a cast in this.
Well,
like, do you still pinch yourselves? Do you guys still pinch yourselves when you get on sets like this at this point in your careers? That people you work with, the stories?
Nah, old hand.
Old hand. Old hand. No. I mean, I remember, but with Chris, I always remember I was working with John Huston, and I said, one day I just said, what's the art of direction, John? He said, casting.
Right.
And he's right. And he, you know, he said, if you cast it right, you don't have to do anything. And like John Huston would say, I said, you never give me any directions. He said, you get paid a great deal of money to do this. You don't need me to tell you what to do. And that is how he is.
Yeah.
He lets you go with it, and because he's cast you right, lets you do everything until something isn't quite right. And then he knows exactly how to tell you where to alter it, and he tells you very quietly. He doesn't show you up in front of the rest of the crew.
But you're speaking to Chris Nolan at the same time. That's how he does it.
Yeah,
that's what I'm saying. That's how Chris Nolan is.
Well, spectacular job, gentlemen. And I'm glad to see that you got to reunite on Now You See Me. I can't wait for that one. And you celebrated your birthday on that set.
Yeah, I did. Yeah.
Fun time. I missed you by one day. Congratulations. Always lovely to talk to you. And
Thank
best
you.
Of luck. This is just fantastic.